solid four corners and three doors. Standing up. Demonstrate for us a solid second salute. Demonstrate for us the 1,000 pound calendar block. Demonstrate for us the roundhouse kick, low, medium, and low. Use your hands up. Demonstrate the outside crescent kick. Demonstrate for us the side blade kick, low, medium, and high. Demonstrate for us the tighter kick. Try that one again. It's easier if you step toward the angle after the first kick. You're actually triangling with your first kick. So step toward me with the kick. Now, rather than put it down where you are, you actually advance with the kick. Alright. This one too, because it's likely that the individual will back away, so you must close down. Just drag him down. Okay, try again. Momentum must be carried between the circle. And the position. That's fine. Okay, that's better. That's good. Show me any advanced combination of block and punch that you can cover. Demonstrate for me a four corner top. shape of butterfly. The second jump game. Some of the methods of motion we use today, like how?
Stepping, spinning, nose thrust, thrusting.
And how about some of the training methods? Mark our code. When you think about your personal experience with this, what would you say has been your most, you know, observable impact it's had on you? What has all of this training done for you
personally?
Any other experiences that you can relate to that your martial arts has been successful and helpful? What does the martial arts code represent to us? Obviously, we have to sort of maintain control of ourselves and have a sense of appreciation for what we can. We also have to be responsible for the skills that we're making. That really has a lot to do with our training. Talk a little bit about the breathing you use when you're striking. What about the inhale and exhale? Is there anything else that you can tell me? When you're striking. Or think about that word close.